Good morning, everyone, and a very warm welcome to you all on behalf of St John's Scottish Episcopal Church in Perth on this Palm Sunday. Today we gather at the gates of Jerusalem. We will follow the triumphal entry of Jesus and look ahead to the events of the coming Holy Week. Like those who gathered on the streets, who waved palms and shouted Hosanna, we gather to worship and praise. They laid their coats before the king on a donkey. We lay before our king all that belongs to us, our experiences, those we have met, what we have thought about this past week, and during our journey of Lent. We lay these down and join the crowd in the praise of Christ. Let us pray. We are on a journey. Travel with us, Lord. A journey through triumph, a journey through hostility. Travel with us, Lord. A journey through crowds, a journey through loneliness. Travel with us, Lord. A journey with companions, a journey alone. Travel with us, Lord. A journey to our end with you. Travel with us, Lord. Travel with us, Lord, through all that comes to us, and help us to know your presence with us every step of the way. Amen.
Sweet Hosanna's ring. Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark chapter 11, beginning to read at verse 1. Glory to Christ our Saviour. When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany near the Mount of Olives, he sent for two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this: 'The Lord needs it, and will send it back here immediately.'" They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, "What are you doing untying the colt?" They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." Give thanks to the Lord for his glorious gospel. Praise to Christ our Lord.
Cheerful here. the Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Mark. It was 2 days before the Passover and the festival of the unleavened bread. The chief priests and the scribes were looking for a way to arrest Jesus by stealth and kill him, for they said,
"Not during the festival, or there may be a riot among the people."
While he was at Bethany, in the house of Simon the leper, as he sat at the table, a woman came with an alabaster jar, a very costly ointment of nard, and she broke open the jar and poured the ointment on his head. But some were there who said to one another in anger,
"Why was the ointment wasted in this way? For this ointment could have been sold for more than 300 denarii, and the money given to the poor."
And they scolded her. But Jesus said,
"Let her alone. Why do you trouble her? She has performed a good service for me. For you always have the poor with you, and you can show kindness to them whenever you wish. But you will not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anointed my body beforehand for its burial. Truly, I tell you, wherever the good news is proclaimed in the whole world, what she has done will be told in remembrance of her."
Then Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went to the chief priests in order to betray him to them. When they heard it, they were greatly pleased and promised to give him money. So he began to look for an opportunity to betray him. On the first day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb is sacrificed, his disciples said to him,
"Where do you want us to go and make the preparations for you to eat the Passover?"
So he sent two of his disciples, saying to them,
"Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him. And wherever he enters, say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks, where is my guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, furnished and ready. Make preparations for us there."
So the disciples set out and went to the city and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When it was evening, he came to the 12, and when they had taken their places and were eating, Jesus said,
"Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me."
They began to be distressed and to say to him, one after another,
"Surely not I."
He said to them,
"It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the bowl with me. For the Son of Man goes as it is written of him. But woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born."
While they were eating, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it and gave it to them and said,
"Take, this is my body."
Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them. And all of them drank from it. He said to them,
"This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I tell you, I will never again drink of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God."
When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives, and Jesus said to them,
"You will all become deserters, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered. But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee.'"
Peter said to him,
"Even though all become deserters, I will not."
Jesus said to him,
"Truly I tell you, this day, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times.
But he said vehemently,
"Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you."
And all of them said the same. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples,
"Sit here while I pray."
He took with him Peter and James and John, and began to be distressed and agitated, and said to them,
I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and keep awake.
And going a little further, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that, if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. He said,
Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I want, but what you want.
He came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter,
Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake 1 hour? Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak.
And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And once more he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy, and they did not know what to say to him. He came a third time and said to them,
Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Enough. The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up. Let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand.
Immediately, while he was speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, and with him there was a crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying,
The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard.
So when he came, he went up to him at once and said,
Rabbi,
and kissed him. And then they laid their hands on him and arrested him. But one of those who stood near with his sword and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear. Then Jesus said to them,
Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day I was with you in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled.
All of them deserted him and fled. A certain young man was following him, wearing nothing but a linen cloth. They caught hold of him, but he left the linen cloth and ran off naked. They took Jesus to the high priest, and all the chief priests, the elders, and the scribes were assembled. Peter had followed him at a distance, right into the courtyard of the high priest. And he was sitting with the guards, warming himself at the fire. Now the chief priests and the whole council were looking for testimony against Jesus to put him to death, but they found none. For many gave false testimony against him, and their testimony did not agree. Some stood up and gave false testimony against him, saying,
We heard him say, I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another, not made with hands.
But even on this point, their testimony did not agree. Then the high priest stood up before them and asked Jesus,
Have you no answer? What is it that they testify against you?
But he was silent and did not answer. Again the high priest asked him,
Are you the Messiah, the Son of the Blessed One?
Jesus said,
I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power, and coming with the clouds of heaven.
Then the high priest tore his clothes and said,
Why do we still need witnesses? You have heard his blasphemy. What is your decision?
All of them condemned him as deserving death. Some began to spit on him, to blindfold him, and to strike him, saying to him,
Prophesy!
The guards also took him over and beat him. While Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the servant girls of the high priest came by. When she saw Peter warming himself, she stared at him and said,
You also were with Jesus, the man from Nazareth.
But he denied it, saying,
I do not know or understand what you are talking about.
And he went out into the forecourt. Then the cock crowed, and the servant girl, on seeing him, began again to say to the bystanders,
This man is one of them.
But again he denied it. Then after a little while, the bystanders again said to Peter,
"Certainly you are one of them, for you are a Galilean."
But he began to curse and he swore an oath.
"I do not know this man you're talking about."
At that moment, the cock crowed for the second time. Then Peter remembered that Jesus had said to him,
"Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times."
And he broke down and wept. As soon as it was morning, the chief priests held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate asked him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
He answered him,
"You say so."
Then the chief priests accused him of many things. Pilate asked him again,
"Have you no answer? See how many charges they bring against you."
But Jesus made no further reply, so that Pilate was amazed. Now at the festival he used to release a prisoner for them, anyone for whom they asked. Now a man called Barabbas was in prison with the rebels who had committed murder during the insurrection. So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to do for them according to his custom. Then he answered them,
"Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?"
For he realised that it was out of jealousy that the chief priest had handed him over. But the chief priest stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. So Pilate spoke to them again,
"Then what do you wish me to do with the man you call the king of the Jews?"
They shouted back,
"Crucify him."
Pilate asked them,
"Why? What evil has he done?"
But they shouted all the more,
"Crucify him."
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them, and after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified. Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is the governor's headquarters, and they called together the whole cohort, and they clothed him in a purple cloak, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him, and they began saluting him.
"Hail, King of the Jews!"
They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloth and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him. They compelled a passerby who was coming in from the country to carry his cross. It was Simon of Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus. Then they brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him and divided his clothes among them, casting lots to decide what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him they crucified two bandits, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by derided him, shaking their heads and saying,
"Aha! You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself! Come down from the cross!"
In the same way, the chief priests, along with the scribes, were also mocking him among themselves and saying,
"He saved others. He cannot save himself. Let the Messiah, the King of Israel, come down from the cross now, so that we may see and believe."
Those who were crucified with him also taunted him. When it was noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon. At 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out with a loud voice,
"Eloi, Eloi, lima sabachthani,"
which means,
"My God, my God, Why have you forsaken me?
When some of the bystanders heard it, they said,
Listen, he's calling for Elijah.
And someone ran, filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink, saying,
Wait, let's see whether Elijah will come to take him down.
Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now when the centurion, who stood facing him, saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said,
Truly, this man was God's son.
There were also women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James the younger, and of Joseph and Salome. These used to follow him and provided for him when he was in Galilee. And there were many other women who had come up with him to Jerusalem. When evening had come, and so it was the day of preparation, that is, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a respected member of the council, who was also himself waiting expectantly for the kingdom of God, went boldly to Pilate and asked him for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate wondered if he were already dead, and summoning the centurion, he asked him whether he had been dead for some time. When he learned from the centurion that he was dead, he granted the body to Joseph. Then Joseph bought a linen cloth, and taking down the body, wrapped it in the linen cloth and laid it in a tomb that had been hewn out of the rock. He then rolled a stone against the door of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Jesus, saw where the body was laid.
Take This morning's intercessions are adapted from common worship. Let us pray. Creator God, we know how much you love this world, so we come trusting in your compassion and faithfulness. As we lift our hearts in our individual homes, may our hosannas not be hollow. Lord, in your mercy, hear us. As Simon from Cyrene was forced to carry your son's cross, be with those who give without counting the cost, not heeding pain, including all carers, nurses, doctors, healers, and all weary in these coronavirus times. Resolute God, show us the small steps that enable us to stick to a task. Give us resilience. Lord, in your mercy, hear us. Your son watched the soldiers gamble to share his clothes. Righteous God, transform the hearts of those who make a profit from their victims and those whose hearts are hardened by their work. Lord, in your mercy, hear us. The thief crucified with Jesus was promised a place in your kingdom. Give pardon and hope and healing to all who work for justice and peace. Stay close to children and families. Lord, in your mercy, hear us. From the cross, Jesus entrusted Mary, his mother, and John, his disciple, to each other's care. Help us to care for one another. May our homes be places of warmth and security. Lord, in your mercy, hear us. Joseph of Arimathea took your son's body away. As we name them silently in our hearts, bless those who are ill. Give faith to the dying. Embrace the bereaved. Give gentleness to those who minister to them. Lord, in your mercy, hear us. And as Simon and Joseph, Mary and John became part of your church in Jerusalem, help us to welcome into your church today people of every colour and creed. God of heaven and earth, as we walk this holy week in these COVID-19 days, make us a people of joy, knowing nothing is out of reach of your cross, nothing beyond the possibility of resurrection. Accept these prayers in Jesus' name. Amen. As our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the time of trial, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
In the passion of the Lord is your protection. In his suffering is your salvation. In his hurt is your healing. In his death is your deliverance. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Lord of the journey, as you set your face towards Jerusalem, we now set our faces towards the world for which you died. May we be your people wherever you send us. Fill our lives as we continue on our journeys to be witnesses to your truth in the world. In the name of Christ. Amen.